Closed captioning provided by the UT Haslam College full-time MBA program. Learn, transform, lead. It all starts here.
Let's get ready to work the win. Let's go.
This is it.
Butch Jones leads the Tennessee Volunteers, running through the tee on a Saturday night.
A passion that knows no equal. For the next 60 minutes, you're tuned to all network coverage of the Tennessee Volunteers.
Let's own expectations, man. Let's go.
From the heart and soul of the Volunteers' day.
I want the whole city of Knoxville to know that it's football time in Tennessee.
This is Tennessee. This is the Butch Jones Show.
I've been waiting for this one.
Brought to you by the Big Orange Debit Card, only from the official bank of the Vols, First Tennessee. By Dish, introducing the Flex Pack. It's a skinny bundle from Dish, official sponsor of the Big Orange. By the Ford F-150, tough runs in our family. See your local Ford dealer today. And by Farm Bureau Insurance, with agents in more communities than any other insurer. Tennessee turns to Farm Bureau Insurance, the official insurance of the Vols.
Tennessee's first ever trip to College Station, and it'll be a game people will talk about for years and years to come. A double overtime thriller. Texas A&M wins it, but Tennessee went down fighting.
Well, we did. And again, the character of this football team, and very, very proud of our players and everyone associated with our football family. But details, details, details. You can't go on the road against a great, great opponent, turn the football over like we did, and make critical mistakes at critical moments, whether missed assignments, missed tackles. And there's a lot of great illustrations in moving forward of our five touchdown drives, Bob. We had only two penalties, one negative yardage football play, and five plays of 20 yards or more. And that's the recipe. When we execute, when we focus on the details, we're a really good and productive offense and a good football team. Again, then the flip side offensively, 41 rushes for 105 yards. But then they have nine rushes that count for 248 yards. And again, it's putting a complete game together. But our players never wavered. They never blinked. And very, very proud of them. And we'll continue to educate them, continue to get better. Everyone says the turnovers. I'm as dumbfounded as anyone. In all of my coaching career, I've never had that. We stress ball security. Even we have them carry footballs to meetings. And so, again, we're going to continue to harp on it. We're going to continue to coach on it. But, again, I'm very, very proud of the resiliency of our football team.
I think one play that really just sums that all up was when Williams looked like he's running for the touchdown and Malik Foreman runs him down at the goal line. He could have given up on that play, but that allowed you to get the ball back.
I thought that one play defined our character of our football team. And obviously Malik Foreman made a tremendous football play. We practiced that in practice. And that scenario has actually occurred a number of times within our practice. And we always show the team that video. So that's something that he had rehearsed. That is something that he had done before in practice. But again, at that moment of the game, when they have that big run, we could have had a quit mentality. And we could have slowed up, and instead 63 effort, we played the play. And that gave us an opportunity to go down and tie it. And also gave us an opportunity later to win the football game.
You got the lead in overtime. Alvin Kamara, you talked about next man up. Jalen Hurd was out. What a day he had.
Well, I think what happened was it was a stage for Alvin Kamara to step up and really showcase his skills. 100 and some odd yards rushing, 100 some odd yards receiving the ball. He's the first back in 20 years of the five power conference teams to have well over 100 yards rushing and well over 100 yards receiving. That's a compliment to him, but also within rushing the ball and also receiving the ball, also his return game from a punt return aspect as well.
It was his third 100-yard rushing game in his career, but he set UT records for total yards by a running back in a game and all-purpose yards. So, I mean, it was a big, big day for him.
Well, very, very proud of him. And like we talk about a next man up mentality, and now, you know what? He's asserted himself as a great running back, and we'll continue to get him the football. We were excited to see how John Kelly would do, and John Kelly didn't disappoint. We got to take care of the football, but he had almost 100 yards rushing. When you look at it, we had 99 plays, which are the most in school history. We had 684 yards of total offense, 282 yards. We're in the rushing category, and we can run the football and also balance. But again, it just comes down to the small details. And everyone in our football program is disappointed. Disappointed that was a hurt locker room. But now you have to learn from it. And in our conference, you got the number one team in the country coming in. I believe this is, we just played, this will be the fourth ranked opponent in a row. And this will be the second top 10 opponent in a row that we're playing. So you can't feel sorry for yourself. You need to continue to improve and get better and learn from these and get ready for Saturday.
It was a day filled with highlights from Kyle Field in College Station. We'll show you those next here on the Butch Jones Show.
This is how the balls pitch in.
The Big Orange family knows the importance of pitching in. Just as Team 120 understands that every play on the field matters, they recognize every item recycled makes a difference. Help Team 120 and the Big Orange family pitch in and promote sustainability one bottle at a time.
Pitch in and do your part to make Neyland Stadium a zero-waste facility. Sponsored by Eastman, Food City, and Waste Connections. Promote sustainability at Tennessee. Good sports always recycle.
Our family, we're not like any other. We're spirited, tough, loyal. We believe in tradition and honor. Generation after generation, we're Vols for life. This is my family. And this is my truck.
It's all about family football and F-150 on a Tennessee Saturday. Ford Truck Month is here. Now get 0 for 72 on a well-equipped 2016 F-150.
Go Vols!
Technology affects us on a daily basis, no matter what we have to do. So when it comes to our banking, everything has to be fast and convenient. For a coach on the go or a family on the go, First Tennessee is the name to know. For online banking and mobile banking. And I couldn't forget my Big Orange debit card. It's with me all the time. And when I pull that out of my wallet, I'm very proud to show the Power T. You'll find the Power T at First Tennessee.
I'm Clay Matthews, and I'm good at football. And so is Verizon. Because now you can watch every live, local, and primetime game on your phone with NFL Mobile, exclusively on Verizon. All without using your data. That's better than good.
It's the best.
And I'm the best.
Watch live NFL games, NFL Red Zone, and more with NFL Mobile. All in HD. Only on America's best network.
Tomorrow's fuel is here today. At home in abundance. America's natural gas is cleaner, more reliable, more affordable, and more efficient. Delivering greater stability and dependability. With lower costs and emissions. Contact your local natural gas provider to look closer at a versatile resource that can serve your family and community for generations to come.
When my father started Food City, he held his stores to the highest standard of quality. He believed that every store should have a knowledgeable butcher so that customers always got the most for their money. Now today, there are Food City stores in four states, and you'll find certified Angus beef in every one of them, and always at a great price. That's value, and that's what you'll find at Food City.
Tennessee, Texas A&M on the national stage again at Kyle Field. In fact, that game overshadowed the Texas-Oklahoma game, and that's saying something in the state of Texas.
We worked very hard with this football program to get us back to this position. And we talked about it with our players all the time is, you know, when we recruited these young men, we sold them on this vision. and we were going to get to this point. Now it's what do you make of it? Again, this week, again, CBS Sports, again, fourth time in the history. It's the first time in the history that we'll have four times in a row on CBS Sports, and that's a four-hour commercial for the University of Tennessee, this great state, this great city, and again, we have to take advantage of that when you get on a national stage like that.
And also, SEC Nation will be here for the Tennessee-Alabama game as well for the pregame. Let's go to the highlights from Texas A&M. They had over 102,000 fans at Kyle Field. First time Tennessee had ever gone to Texas A&M in College Station. And this is a game full of highlights.
And I thought, Bob, we handled the situation. We handled the environment exceptionally well. This is the first series, the second down and two, and you can see Derek Barnett, we're applying pressure. He does a great job, comes, disrupts the quarterback, and then caught Kelly Jr. And they wanted to get off to a fast start, and they're trying to isolate their receiver down here at the bottom on a post route. And TK's in the middle of the field where he should be and gets a momentum swing for us. And now we have to capitalize on offense, but great way to start the game.
Barnett has been a man possessed, hasn't he?
Yes, he has. And staying with that theme with Derek Barnett again, you can see impacting the quarterback. And we always talk about everything is quarterback oriented with being able to apply pressure. And here's Derek coming and getting a sack. And that was a second down and six at that particular time. And they're actually, Bob, if you can see, they're in max protection here. And they're sliding. And they're trying to actually double team him. And he does a great job with his relentless effort.
Talk about Josh Dobbs' day. Here he connects with Juwan Jennings.
Yeah, and I thought Juwan Jennings played an exceptional game. This was his type of game in terms of the physicality aspect of it, and was really proud of him.
Did the offense change at all with Jalen Hurd being not able to play?
No, we were able to create, I thought, a little bit more space with Elvin and John Kelly, but really there is absolutely no changes schematically. Here, this is quarterback keeper, just a zone read. Josh does a great job of getting the ball north and south here and puts us in scoring position.
Such a gifted runner, he makes people miss.
Then first and goal here. This is Juwan Jennings getting into his high school days of playing quarterback, and you can see here we're going to actually step up and we're going to put Joshua Dobbs in motion. Like we're checking the play, we'll snap the ball to Elvin. Here comes the reverse, and there's the six to Josh Dobbs. I thought a perfectly timed play, and our players executed it exceptionally well.
Dobbs' second career touchdown reception.
He hits Jason Kroom here, and Jason does a great job with physicality and getting the ball for a big play for us. That was on a second down and six play. And then here's Josh again to Juwan Jennings. And this was a critical moment in the game because it's 28-7 and it's third down and five here. Good job of pass protection by our offensive front. And then again, good pass in the throw turns Jennings into a runner.
Quick burst by Alvin right up the middle.
And this was a football team that has excelled in the red zone. It's excelled in goal line packages all year, and we knew we were going to be challenged in the red zone again. Alvin hits the hole exceptionally well, does a great job. You can see the offensive line does a great job of really blocking the second level. And you can see our left tackle, Brett Kendrick, does a good job getting enough peace on the linebacker, and then Elvin does a great job of getting the ball into the end zone.
You mentioned A&M was number one in red zone defense. Tennessee was 6-for-6 in the red zone.
And then again, second and eight here. We need a momentum play. We need our defense to come up with something big. And here's a tip ball, and here's Colton Jumper coming, and great effort, and gets us the pick, gets us the turnover that we needed.
Jumper also led the team in tackles with 10 on the day, so a big day for Colton Jumper.
Well, here's a third down and one stop by Colton Jumper. And again, he does a great job of winning what we call at the junction point. You can see he's a linebacker at the top of your screen, and he's able to keep his shoulders square and work down the field. And he's able to get off the block and then be very, very disruptive in a tackle for a loss on a critical third and one play. That changes everything, Bob, from a field standpoint, because now you go from probably being in a punt safe situation to now being able to either rush the punter or being able to return the football. This is an option route to Elvin Kamara here, and Josh does a great job, but again, We're playing one of the best defensive fronts in the Southeastern Conference, and I thought our offensive line did a great job of really handling this. Very, very firm pocket. We call that being in the home position. Josh can be very comfortable being at home. Set his feet. Elvin does a great job, and then we get him the ball over the middle, and then a really, really good job here of the contact phase of the run, getting the ball north and south and getting yards after the catch. And then we talk about first up with just a whole another mentality. Again, Elvin gave us a whole another spark out of the backfield. Here's another completion to Juwan Jennings. Again, run after the catch, getting the ball north and south. And we know he's one of the most physical football players we have on our football team.
Dobbs on the day had 398 yards passing. He was 28 of 47.
Here's a critical play again. It's 28 to 14, and this is a third and 10. And the great thing about this is Josh gets the ball to his third read. Again, getting the ball north and south, making the first defender miss. Josh again running the football, running exceptionally hard, getting the ball, getting a first down, and getting us in the scoring territory.
And you talk about John Kelly.
Well, again, John Kelly's a hard-nosed physical football player, does a great job with the internal runs, and the mark of a great back is even when they get tackled, they're always falling forward. And John is one of those individuals who really, really runs behind his pads, and it was great to see him take the most of his opportunity. And again, you can see the leverage, which we speak about all the time, the pad level, and getting the ball north and south. And when you get the ball down there, you have to get the ball north and south.
He had 13 carries for 89 yards and that touchdown on the day.
Critical fourth and one play. Just an inside zone play. Again, hitting the hole, getting the ball north and south. Our offensive front does a great job of providing the run lanes and then, again, making the first individual miss and getting the ball north and south and running exceptionally hard.
You know, again, you had to make some adjustments, too, in the offensive line when Dylan Wiseman went out.
Well, we did. You know, Dylan Wiseman went down. Jayshon Robertson went down. And Coleman Thomas came in. Venzel Bowyer came in. It was great to see these individuals perform and perform well again, getting the ball north and south, not being denied at the end zone and at the goal line.
Alvin Kamara had 127 yards rushing, 161 yards receiving.
Again, you know, we talk about tackling right here. This should be a 2 yard gain right here. And again, we don't do a good job of tackling. We got to get off the block. And again, these are things that can't happen. But I thought that this play defines who we are as a football program and Malik Foreman and never saying quit. Right here, this football team could have said this play is over with. You see where Malik is at the 30 yard line. He's going to score, give up. It's 35-28 with less than 2 minutes to go. And again, I thought this defines what we're all about as a football team. Touchback, it gives us an opportunity to go down in a 1 minute situation and tie the football game. We call this technique a pin and punch. And a fumble is always caused by the defender you never see. And again, we practice it all the time in practice, and it was great to see him execute this.
So now Tennessee's got the ball back. It's first and 15. You got a score under 2 minutes to go and down by a score.
I thought our players did a really good job of handling the 1 minute situation, but also all the situational football that presented itself. Here's a true freshman again, Tyler Byrd. Josh does a great job, but if you look at the stability in the pocket, he's able to set his feet. And then Tyler Byrd does a good job of getting the ball north and south. And again, run after the catch. He's going to be a special player for us. 49 seconds to go in the game, second and 10. Again, great job by Josh Dobbs. This is his third read in the progression. They're bringing pressure. He does a great job of standing in the home position. Gives the ball in the check down to Alvin Kamara. And then don't be denied. Get the ball in the end zone.
Pulls Tennessee to within a point.
First possession of overtime, a lot of people said, well, why wouldn't you go for it? Well, first possession of overtime, you have to come away with points. It's absolutely critical that you come away with points. And a good snap, good hold, good kick, and it gives us an opportunity to put us up by three.
So now Tennessee has to stop Texas A&M.
Again, critical plays. It's third and one. Our defensive front does a great job, and they actually lose about a yard there, and it sets up, you know, another opportunity for a blocked field goal to try to win the game in the first overtime. Again, you can see the penetration by our front, and our guys doing a great job with leverage, and came up a little bit short. Very, very disappointing, but it's how do we learn from these mistakes and how do we move forward? A lot of football left to be played. Sitting at 5-1 at the halfway mark with the number one football team in the country coming in here. And again, the good thing was everyone was disappointed and they understand where we need to go to get better. But again, these players, they give their all each and every day, and I'm just so proud of them. And now again, as you saw through the video, it's all the small details.
But you're down two scores, 7 minutes to go, and this team didn't give up and fought back. You've got to be proud of that.
I am. And on the road, great environment. Doesn't beat Neyland, but great environment. But again, just really proud of our players. But we have to build some momentum. And again, it's disappointing. The turnovers are unacceptable. The penalties are unacceptable. That falls on me, falls on the coaching staff. We'll work hard every day, but our players understand. And again, we have to come back to work today, and we will.
Tennessee has a tough one against Texas A&M and a tough one coming up this week against Alabama. We'll talk about that and more next here on the Butch Jones Show.
It's time to honor the Tennessee Vol Scholar of the Week, brought to you by Nissan. Proud supporter of college athletics, shop ChooseNissan.com. Innovation that excites. This week, we recognize LaTroy Lewis as our Vol Scholar of the Week. LaTroy majored in kinesiology and wants to go to chiropractic school. LaTroy is a 2016-2017 Vol Scholar, and he had a 3.0 GPA last year. That's what makes him the Vol Scholar of the Week.
Good or better? The Hyundai Tucson versus the Ford Escape. Estimated fueling costs, the Ford's higher.
Whoa.
Estimated routine repairs, the Ford's higher.
What's happening?
In fact,
guys?
Hyundai has the lowest 5-year cost to own of all brands for 2016. So again, Ford's higher.
Guys?
That's really high.
Very funny! Ha ha!
Better is the reason to buy Hyundai. The 2016 Tucson from Hyundai.
I just want to break the rules. I just want to break the rules.
There's people who care where I'm going, and good friends who welcome me home. So get a full tank of freedom, drive the American road. And with a full tank of freedom, find your own highway. We'll take you wherever you go. Take you wherever you go.
From hard work, humble beginnings, and the red clay of Tennessee, greatness is built brick by brick. This is Coach Philip Fulmer. General Shale and I are proud supporters of Tennessee football.
The Butch Jones Show is being brought to you by Verizon, the better network. Verizon, official wireless provider of the Tennessee Volunteers.
By the natural gas utilities and pipeline companies in Tennessee.
Natural gas.
By UT Medical Center, Tennessee's hospital. UT Medical Center, wisdom for your life. And by Food City, the tailgating capital of Big Orange Country and proud sponsor of UT Athletics. Food City, value every day.
I'm Maddie Glab here with Eric Ainge. This is the Film Room, a segment where Eric breaks it down. Today we're talking about defense, specifically the nickel. So when I think of base defense package, I think of 4-3, 3-4, but we're talking about a 4-2-5.
why run the nickel as your base package?
Well, let's start with that. 4-2-5. 4-2-5 defensive backs. And you ask, why run the nickel? A lot of offensive teams now are running the spread. They have three receivers, and you got to have a guy who's athletic enough to get out there and play man-to-man, zone, get involved in the run game.
Okay.
This guy right here has to be able to do a little bit of everything. You know, so a nickelback to me has to be three things. He has to be really intelligent, very athletic, and really tough. He's got to have a linebacker mentality, safety, corner athleticism, and quarterback intelligence right here. I mean, he's kind of has to have everything. Let's watch this play right here. Georgia is guarding their best player, man-to-man across the board, down set hut, ball snapped. Beats him off the line. He should have had maybe outside leverage. His help was inside. He gets beat, but he makes up with great athleticism and a very good football play.
Is that good luck by Golden, or is he really making an amazing play right
I
there?
Saw that all week, and he knocks the ball down. He's not even looking. He sticks his hand up and knocks the ball down. I think, take it back just a little bit right there, right here. See, he's just now putting his hand up, and he just put his arms up to catch the football. Mm-hmm. Good job by the receiver having laid hands.
Right.
Also, great job by Golden waiting until the receiver shows his hands to put his arm up. That way he doesn't know where the ball's coming. It's just called late hands. Good technique, intelligent, athletic, very good play by him. Let's go to the next one right here.
So does the nickel got to be a guy who knows it all? You said quarterback mentality.
He has to be. He has to be smart enough. He has to know what everybody else on the field is doing. I mean, safety, middle linebacker, you hear that all the time. This guy is becoming that position right here in major college football. Here's Rashawn Golden. He's the nickel. Down set hut, ball snapped, comes out. Quarter halves. It's cover four here, cover six there.
Zone defense.
He's patient, waits. Here comes Appleby. He gets flushed out of the pocket. He knows no one's threatening his zone, sticks his foot in the ground, and goes and gets a shot on the quarterback. Good legal hit. Again, toughness. Intelligent, athletic, tough. Great play by him right there to stay patient in his zone and then go get a hit on number 12.
So is running the nickel as your base, is that becoming more prominent in college football now?
It is. You know, just about every college football team, even if they're a run-first football team, they're doing it with the zone read, the read option. They're spreading the field, using the entire field, and they have to have these guys, these nickelbacks. I mean, that becomes the hinge point of the entire defense.
The 4-2-5, that nickel, he's got to be a smart one.
Tailgating doesn't have to be work anymore. Kick off your game day with Tailgate Tennessee. Located inside Circle Park, Tailgate Tennessee offers premium tailgate packages with private tents, TVs, food, and much more. You park the car, we'll do the rest. For more information, visit tailgatetennessee.com. Presented by Zaxby's and Dish.
It's been used universally for decades. The consummate attaboy. Good job. Way to go. Because nothing says a job well done like the classic high five. So, if someone wants to give you five, the polite thing to do is say thank you. That's why for 5 years in a row, Farm Bureau Insurance has been proud to receive the J.D. Power Award for highest customer satisfaction among auto insurers in the Southeast region. Farm Bureau Insurance. Tennessee turns to us.
Our family. We're not like any other. We're spirited, tough, loyal. We believe in tradition and honor. Generation after generation revolves for life. This is my family. And this is my truck.
It's all about family football and F-150 on a Tennessee Saturday. Ford Truck Month is here. Now get 0 for 72 on a well-equipped 2016 F-150.
Go Vols!
Excellence is a journey that you choose to take. It's a choice to be the academic medical center in the region. It's a focus on not asking what's next, but discovering it. Excellence is having physicians on the cutting edge of medicine, training future generations of physicians. The University of Tennessee Medical Center, wisdom for your life.
There's something out there, something stirring, something wild. Introducing the Wild family of instant games from the Tennessee Lottery. Win up to $500,000. Out of nowhere. Only from the Tennessee Lottery. Game-changing fun.
We are believers. Trust is earned in the field, where a full day's work will always tell the truth. We believe in what we do and what we have done. Who are we? Number one in subcompact tractors, number one in compact excavators, and number one in diesel engines. We are Kubota.
The Vol Network now turns the spotlight on Team 120, brought to you by Hyundai, proud supporter of college football and loyal fans everywhere.
Tennessee football does not take special teams lightly.
We're one of the unique places in the country that actually attacks all four phases on a daily basis and put a high, high priority on special teams play here.
Coach Jones and his coaching staff know special teams can change the game.
You never know. One play on special teams can be the difference between winning and losing.
You never know. So you talk to your guys constantly about having a kind of a one-and-done mentality.
The players on that unit understand their efforts usually go unnoticed.
I've always known that I could go 4 years here and never get any recognition for what I do. No one ever says my name, and I'm fine with that.
And every time special teams takes the field, they play lights out, not for themselves, but for the team. And once in a while, you do get noticed.
What a play by Lovingood, running down the field, caught the ball really over his head.
The play that Riley Lovingood made, I've never seen a play like that.
We knew we were going to put the ball close to the goal line, and I snapped the ball, and then I'm running down. I see the returner. I see his eyes in the air, and I see him fair catch it, and then just start running forward. So then I knew all of a sudden, I'm a peripheral, I saw the ball in the air, so I knew that he wasn't gonna catch it. I just tracked the ball and I caught it, and I looked up, I was on the like 3 or 4 yard line, and Evan Varies in front of me jumping up and down like, what'd you just do?
Riley Lovingood, who snapped it, was the first one down and made the over-the-shoulder catch.
Long snapper Riley Lovingood made an unthinkable play and created opportunity for his team.
Eason back to throw. Sets up. Finally, now he's hit. Ball's loose in the end zone. Tennessee falls on it. Touchdown, Tennessee. How about that?
After we scored the touchdown, they all came off the field, and especially my old roommate, Khalil. He came off the field and grabbed me, hugged me, and was telling me that was on me. And that was a really good feeling.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about.
For Lovingood, it's not about getting recognized for making a play. It's about making a play to help his brothers.
I was just making a play for my team. Just not really thinking about it, just going and doing. That's what Juwan did. That's just what you do sometimes. You don't think about it, you just go and get the ball.
That's what it's all about. And you hope that if you can get to that point with all of the players in your program, then you truly have a team.
For the Butch Jones Show, I'm Maddie Glab.
Riley Lovingood, the SEC Special Teams Player of the Week for that play and helping Tennessee win the game against Georgia. You never know, as you always say, when that next play might be a game changer.
You're exactly right. And all the things he spoke about with the returner in a pooch situation, calling for a fair catch so he's running behind him. And I still think it's one of the most remarkable plays for a long snapper. I've never seen a long snapper run down the field and catch the punt. And just so proud of him. And you talk about character, not just competitive character, but character with him as a person and his family. And again, another Tennessee kid making a difference. And he points to Juwan Jennings, another Tennessee player making a difference at the University of Tennessee.
You know, it's so amazing, too, as he said, snappers only get their name in the paper when they make a bad one. But Riley works so hard to be a perfect snapper. And his snaps are right on the money.
He's very, very driven, works his craft every single day, even has a weight room routine that works his craft. And again, another individual who's selfless, and playing at Tennessee means everything to him. And he exemplifies what we have in our football program.
Riley Lovingood, one of the key members of Tennessee's special teams. We'll ask the coach next here on the Butch Jones Show.
The Vols rushed for 120 yards or more this week. Download the Dunkin' Donuts app and get a free medium hot or iced coffee today. Vol fans, run on Dunkin'.
Sophie, his 13th birthday. Gift? We've got you. Guitar? Coming tomorrow. Road game today? Surprise party tomorrow. Change of plans. Game tomorrow.
No, birthday tomorrow.
Hotel! Hotel!
Guitar? Reroute.
birthdays are on birthdays.
Party, relocate. UPS My Choice makes rerouting packages easy.
Mom!
How we're helping companies solve for the needs of customers like Sophie.
The 2016 Nissan Altima. An IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus. With forward emergency braking that could stop for you. Get to your local Nissan store today. Take on sudden stops. It's a Nissan, a proud partner of the Tennessee Volunteers.
Go Bulls!
With CPI Security's InTouch system, you get complete protection, control, and convenience right at your fingertips. Arm your system, lock your doors, and make sure everyone is safe when you're not home. During an emergency, you're quickly connected to our award-winning monitoring station, delivering a fast, personal response when you need it. Call CPI today to get a complete InTouch system, including an interior and outdoor HD camera, touchscreen door lock, and thermostat installed free. That's over $2,100 in free equipment.
Tennessee fans, it's time to lock in. On sale now is the official Tennessee football fan t-shirt for 2016. Lock-in shirts are on sale now at Vol shops on campus and at participating fan shops across the state, including Alumni Hall, Hound Dogs, Walgreens, Sports Seasons, and Food City. That's Lock-In, presented by Dish. You asked, he'll answer. This is Ask the Coach, presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Check them out at academy.com/vols for your chance to win Tennessee football tickets. No purchase necessary.
Coach, the question this week from Doug Lane, and he wants to know, you've had several reserves step up and play bigger and bigger roles. How do you get that next man up mentality?
Well, it's something we talk about in our football program all the time, and when that opportunity presents itself, go take the most of it like Colton Jumper is doing. But there's a difference between being ready and prepared. Everyone says they're ready, but are you prepared for when that opportunity comes? You make the most of it. And it may only be two snaps, it may be three snaps, but what you're doing is you're earning that trust amongst your coaches and your peers. And make those three snaps the best snaps you can possibly have. And if those three great snaps are winning snaps, you'll get more snaps. We've had a lot of players do that, and that's what's been very, very special about Team 120.
Yeah, a bunch of them did it in the Texas A&M game. We're joined by John Bryce of the Vol Network.
Coach, along those same lines, I wonder how much of this is a result of building it to this mentality all through the years, and how do you continue to grow it? What's the next step there?
Well, you're exactly right. First of all, it's the foundation of growing it throughout the number of years, and it's embedded in our football program. It's in our DNA. But you have to continue to grow and elevate that, because a 30-year roster changes every single year. So we have freshmen come in that have these roles, but they haven't been in the program for 2 or 3 years to understand the next man up mentality. And really, what does it take to prepare yourself? Because it's difficult, especially for an 18-year-old individual who's been highly recruited, been the star on their football team in high school, and then they come here and they're not in that type of role yet. They're still developing and they're not playing much. Then all of a sudden, they're forced into a game situation, whether it's an offense, defense, or a role on special teams. And how do you embrace that role, but also how do you excel in that role? And that's something we talk about all the time.
Coach, let's talk about the health of your football team. You hope to get some guys back this week, don't you?
Jason McVay may be our most valuable employee this week. And it was a hard-fought football game. Very, very, very physical. Our players laid it on the line. And we spoke right after the game of what this week means to us and the preparation that it's going to take. And it gets back to what John and I spoke about, ready versus being prepared. And we have to make sure we're prepared. And it starts with our health. It starts with our sleep. It starts with our nutrition, taking care of our bodies. And it starts today in the training room.
Third Saturday in October, a special one for Tennessee fans everywhere. Alabama coming to town in a big, big game again.
Looking forward to it. Neyland effect needs to be in full effect, which I know they will. And, you know, when you go on the road and you visit great places, it makes you realize, though, there's only one Tennessee.
That's right. Coach, good luck. Have a good week and beat Bama.
Thanks, Bob.
Coach Butch Jones, we'll look ahead to Alabama next here on the Butch Jones Show.
Fans, please direct your attention to the video board for tonight's Loyal Fan of the Game, brought to you by Hyundai. Vol fans are loyal. Hyundai fans are loyal too. Enough to be ranked number one in customer loyalty 6 years in a row.
Being a First Tennessee customer makes you very, very comfortable and very confident that you're getting the best of the best in terms of customer service, innovation, and updated technologies each and every day. First Tennessee provides everything to be successful in a convenient way, especially with the online banking and the mobile banking. And the most powerful word you can use is trust, and I trust them with all my banking. I tell anyone who wants to bank with the best, follow me, the First Tennessee.
Why are the clothes always so damp? Why do they take so long to dry?
Because we have an electric dryer.
Dad, why is this house so cold?
It's electric heat. Just bundle up and go ask your mother.
Mom, why is the...
Go ask your father.
Why did this take so long? Why is it dry? Why is it burnt?
Maybe we should finally switch to natural gas.
Finally!
Why haven't you switched to natural gas?
Our family, we're not like any other. We're spirited, tough, loyal. We believe in tradition and honor. Generation after generation, we're Vols for life. This is my family. And this is my truck.
It's all about family football and F-150 on a Tennessee Saturday. Ford Truck Month is here. Now get 0 for 72 on a well-equipped 2016 F-150.
Go Vols!
Life can be unpredictable.
Oh.
And with gaps in Medicare, you need to be prepared for whatever comes up. Our Medicare supplements cover many of the costs so you can have peace of mind, which has become quite a buzzword lately.
Buzzword? Peace of mind is three words.
Okay, Einstein, let her finish.
Have questions about Medicare supplements? Visit fbhealthplans.com or your local Farm Bureau office. We've got you covered.
One Tennessee. One sustainable goal. Zero waste in Neyland Stadium. No sort recycling. Now, zero excuses. Made possible by Eastman, Food City, and Waste Connections. No sort makes it easy to be a good sport. Tackle sustainability. At Tennessee, good sports always recycle.
The Butch Jones Show is being delivered by UPS, helping companies solve for today's rising customer expectations. Visit ups.com/solvers to find out more. By Hyundai, proud supporter of college football and loyal fans everywhere. By Eastman Chemical Company, promoting sustainability. Remember, good sports always recycle. And by Farm Bureau Health Plans, we've got you covered. Get a rate quote online at fbhealthplans.com or at your local Tennessee Farm Bureau office. This is Exact Science, brought to you by Humana, your partner in health.
Obviously, ACL injuries are a very big problem when they occur, so a lot of what we focus on is trying to prevent those injuries. So there's a number of things that we look for to try to make sure that our players aren't at high risk for the injury, and we'll assess them a lot when they get here, and then again throughout the time they're here, try to make sure that they don't have that problem. So now we're here at our Biodex machine where we would test our players' strength and explosive power in both their quadriceps muscle and their hamstring muscle. We'll look at their body weight and how much force they're generating compared to their body weight to make sure that's appropriate. We'll also look at left and right side to make sure that they're very close on both sides in case they have a weakness. We want to address that. So this is a test we'll do when they first show up on campus and then again after any injury to make sure that they've regained their strength prior to return to play. So Daryl's going to push against the machine and it's going to resist his motion, but it's also going to measure the amount of force that he generates, both kicking up and pulling back. We'll do several reps of this at different speeds that we'll be able to compare to left and right side and also per his body weight to decide if he needs to have a rehab program focused on his quadriceps strength or his hamstring strength, either one. One of the ways that we'll strengthen our players' hamstrings to prevent knee injuries as well is with what they call an eccentric strengthening or deceleration. So the hamstrings protect the ACL when you're running and stopping and changing direction. So one of the good ways we can strengthen those hamstrings is doing a Nordic hamstring exercise, which Daryl will demonstrate. This is a great way to strengthen the hamstrings for deceleration. So he supports his body as long as he can and as slow as he can as his hamstrings have to lengthen. And that's a deceleration effect on his hamstrings, which helps protect the ACL. We'll also look at single leg jump landing in our athletes as they move side to side. This is a great exercise that we'll use to strengthen them, but also a way that we'll watch them move to see if they look like they have any weaknesses. So Daryl's gonna go from one piece of the tape to the other, side jumping, looking for good stability when he lands and good muscle absorption. So he's gonna bend his knees and hips when he lands. He's gonna land with good balance. He's gonna go side to side. So again, we're looking for good position of the knee over top of the toe and making sure that he's absorbing his shock and dropping his weight so he's not landing stiff.
Monday night means more Tennessee football. Join us from 8 to 9 p.m. for the Big Orange Hotline. Bob Kessling, Jeff Francis, and Pat Ryan break down Saturday's ballgame live from the patio of Dead End Barbecue in West Knoxville. That's the Big Orange Hotline. Every Monday night.
You know, these Zaxby's fried pickles really take me back to Meemaw's kitchen.
Yeah, Meemaw really would have loved these. Is that a time machine?
Yep, and I brought Meemaw back with me.
That's not Meemaw.
Ooh, okay, let's get you back inside.
Better than grandma's? Maybe. Indescribably good? Definitely. Fried pickles are back. Lightly breaded, fried to perfection, and served with ranch sauce. Try them before they're gone. Zaxby's. Good or better?
The Hyundai Santa Fe Sport versus the Ford Edge.
Should we be wearing helmets?
The Santa Fe Sport has an available multi-view camera system. The Edge doesn't.
What was that?
On the Hyundai, available auto emergency braking. On the Ford, nope.
Hey, what's with the axe?
And only the Hyundai is backed by America's best warranty.
Oh, no.
Better is the reason to buy Hyundai.
I'm out.
The 2017 Santa Fe Sport from Hyundai.
When my father started Food City, he held his stores to the highest standard of quality. He believed that every store should have a knowledgeable butcher so that customers always got the most for their money. Now today, there are Food City stores in four states, and you'll find certified Angus beef in every one of them, and always at a great price. That's value, and that's what you'll find at Food City.
I'm Clay Matthews, and I'm good at football. And so is Verizon, because now you can watch every live, local, and primetime game on your phone with NFL Mobile, exclusively on Verizon, all without using your data. That's better than good.
It's the best.
And I'm the best. Watch live NFL games, NFL Red Zone, and more with NFL Mobile, all in HD, only on America's best network.
Clausen out of the shotgun, back to throw, looking. Firing over the middle, the pass is complete. It's complete to Kelly Washington. Washington's going to walk in for a Tennessee touchdown. 70 yards as Casey Clausen found Kelly Washington on the slant. Washington beat the defense and rolled in for a bomb.
Of course, we miss Jalen, you know, we miss having Jalen. But we have a next man up mentality, so next man up. And I was just going to do my job. I mean, it wasn't more stress this week than it was last week. I mean, we all prepared like we're the number one guy every week. You know, we stayed in the game to the very end. Nobody got down. Nobody got ahead of themselves. You know, we just stayed in the moment and were able to come back and bring the OT, but came up a little bit short. It's tough, but at the same time, it's uplifting because we know we're the ones shooting ourselves in the foot. So we eliminate that, and you know, the sky's the limit. Maybe 1,000 yards.
What a performance by Alvin Kamara. 288 total offensive yards, most by a running back in Tennessee history in a single game. 312 all-purpose yards, also a record. 127 yards rushing, 161 yards passing, 3 touchdowns. What a day.
It was phenomenal, Bob. I said before the game on CBS that the nation, if they didn't know Alvin Kamara, would know him after yesterday. I really felt like he was poised to break out, and he's such a selfless team player. I thought maybe the most amazing thing said about Alvin post-game yesterday was Todd Kelly, who said, if you know him, he's a great football player. He's an even better person off the field. And he is. He has an infectious personality. He's really fun to be around. And on those 288 yards from scrimmage, Bob, he averaged 11 yards a touch. He averaged a first down plus every time he touched the ball from scrimmage. So 26 touches for 288 yards.
Well, and then he had 3 punt returns. So he had 29 touches of the game. So that's remarkable.
And a kickoff return, 30 total touches.
That's right.
Just
an
incredible workhorse day for Alvin Kamara. That was a national signature moment for Alvin Kamara. But I know he wanted the win.
99 plus Tennessee ran off against Texas A&M. That was pretty astounding as well.
And just remarkable. And we've heard them talk tempo for a number of years, and people at times this year have questioned their tempo. And I've said this team has the ability to go up tempo when it needs to, and it's growing into being able to slow down the tempo and grind out some things on the ground. But played at a really breakneck speed yesterday. The defense kept getting the ball back to the offense in the second half to facilitate that rally, and just a really impressive performance. I mean, Tennessee, in my opinion, was clearly the better team, but you can't commit 7 turnovers against anybody, especially on the road in the SEC.
But the thing that's carried through this football team the whole season is the defense makes adjustments in the second half and pretty much shuts the other team down to allow the offense to come back.
Bob, I think Tennessee has about a negative 40 scoring differential in the first halves of games this year. In the second halves of games, they've doubled that up. They're plus 80, plus right around 80, 83 points in the second half of games this year. Really remarkable turnaround. And again, it speaks to the buy-in of these guys, the poise and the absence of panic on that sideline and in the locker room at halftime.
Time to announce our AutoZone player of the game. Get in the zone, AutoZone. And in the zone was Alvin Kamara. Congratulations to Alvin, our AutoZone player of the game. With all the yards he rolled up and, of course, the 3 touchdowns. And really, he was a guy that helped spark Tennessee to the 2 overtimes to get him there. Tennessee couldn't finish the job, and that's what Alvin said was the most important thing about the day. But still, his numbers were remarkable. For the auto parts, accessories, and advice you need, get in the zone, AutoZone. We'll talk about Tennessee and Bama next here on the Butch Jones Show.
The Butch Jones Show is being brought to you by CPI Security, proud corporate sponsor of the Vols. By Humana, over 50 years of experience in the healthcare industry. Humana, your partner in health.
By the Natural Gas Utilities and Pipeline Companies in Tennessee.
Natural gas.
And by the Tennessee Education Lottery. Proud to have raised over $3.5 billion to support education programs in Tennessee.
Excellence is finding ways to solve new challenges. It's one of the reasons we created our 6 Centers of Excellence. Physicians from different disciplines working together to provide better solutions for you. It's a collaborative effort that pushes us to be our best and to provide you with the best care possible. Excellence is a journey that we take every day. The University of Tennessee Medical Center. Wisdom for your life.
There's something out there. Something stirring. Something wild. Introducing the Wild family of instant games from the Tennessee Lottery. Went up to $500,000. Out of nowhere. Only from the Tennessee Lottery. Game-changing fun.
You are the man of the hour, the king of the castle. Your subjects look upon you in awe and anticipation because you're about to make their culinary dreams come true. Guess you should have had natural gas.
Oh, no!
Our family, we're not like any other. We're spirited, tough, loyal. We believe in tradition and honor. Generation after generation revolves for life. This is my family.
And this is my truck.
It's all about family football and F-150 on a Tennessee Saturday. Ford Truck Month is here. Now get 0 for 72 on a well-equipped 2016 F-150.
Go Vols!
To win championships, first and foremost, you have to win with people. It's all about an organization. It's all about a total commitment. Just like First Tennessee, they win with people on a daily basis. From the professionalism to the convenience that they provide myself and my family, and also just staying up on the top of things, the latest trends in banking, the customer service, the convenience, and the passion by which they go by each and every day. They understand the volunteer spirit.
Time now for the First Tennessee First Look, a scouting report and look ahead at the Vols' upcoming opponents. Brought to you by First Tennessee, the official bank of the Vols.
I'm VFL Eric Ainge. It's time for the First Tennessee First Look. We have Alabama in Neyland Stadium. It's the third Saturday in October. We know what to expect from Nick Saban's Alabama defense. Expect a lot of man-to-man. Their front seven is very good, and their defensive line can put pressure on the quarterback, especially their defensive tackles. On offense, their coordinator Lane Kiffin has a motto, think players, not plays. He wants to get the ball to his playmakers in space. He's a pro-style guy, single back, three receivers, sometimes two tight ends, and he has some good players to get the ball to. Spotlight true freshman quarterback Jalen Hurts. He's a very good player. He can run and he can throw. We'll have to contain him. Wide receiver Calvin Ridley. He can stretch the field. He can do everything. And tight end O.J. Howard. He can present a lot of problems for a defense playing first, second, and third down. I'm VFL Eric Ainge, and that's the First Tennessee First Look.
Alabama rolls to town after beating Arkansas 49-30 on Saturday in Fayetteville. So another road game for Alabama, but right now it doesn't seem to matter who they play or where they play. They're pretty good.
No, they're really a machine right now, Bob, but they're not quite as good defensively as what we've seen in the past. Gave up over 400 yards and the 30 points at Arkansas. What they are doing extremely well defensively is in the red zone, and they've given up 13 scores but only four touchdowns and only one rushing touchdown all season. That only occurred yesterday at Arkansas. So Alabama has been really good defending the run, particularly in the red zone. And then the Fitzpatrick kid at defensive back, Bob, set a new school record yesterday with three interceptions, including a 100-yard return for six.
Yeah, their defense scores points.
Their defense does score points. In fact, they are tied for the lead in the nation with seven defensive touchdowns, 11 non-offensive touchdowns this year. That's more than many FBS teams.
Yep. Big topic this week will be the injury situation at Tennessee. That hadn't seemed to matter all season. I mean, it's just whoever steps up next, it's your time to play and go play.
Yeah, I don't know exactly how many games Tennessee will win down the stretch, but I know that this team believes it can win every game regardless of who is on the field for the Vols, and it believes that they're going to have a chance at the end of every game. I think they've proved so far that they can do that.
But it would be nice to get some of the guys back
for
Alabama.
They need as much health as possible to face the Crimson Tide.
So it'll be a big challenge. It's the third Saturday in October. It's Tennessee and Alabama Saturday at Neyland Stadium. Again, the game will kick off at 3:30, and there'll be a lot of hoopla about this big, big game. We'll show you all the highlights of Tennessee and Bama next week right here on the Butch Jones Show.
This has been a presentation of the Vol Network, produced by IMG, the world's premier sports media and entertainment company, produced at the Hand Digital Studios.